Hello students. Students, this class is of the second part of the Indus Valley Civilization's origin. And in the last class, in the first part, I told you people about the origins of the Indus Valley Civilization. We have started this class from that period. So before that, I told you people about the origin of the Earth also, that Earth came in its present form from the, by passing through the different theories of the different scholars, like the plate tectonic theory was there, then Big Bang theory, heliocentric theory, geocentric theory was there, then cloud dust theory or the nebula theory. So by this theory, ultimately the Earth came in its existence. And present period is the Holocene period. And to get this Holocene period from 4.6 billion years, that was the estimated age of the Earth, it has crossed different phases. So there are different phases of the eon, like the Aeon was there, then Archaeon, then Protozoic, then Phanerozoic eon was there. And the last eon further subdivided into the different eras. The eras like the Paleozoic, Mesozoic and the Cenozoic. And Cenozoic era further subdivided into the eons, that is the Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene, Pliocene, Pleistocene, and present is the Holocene. So that's how from 4.6 billion to present, that was the journey of the Earth also. And simultaneously, we the human being, the true Homo sapiens, has also crossed different paths also, or different stages, just like the Earth. Just if we take example, the human beings evolved from the apes, if we accept the Darwin's theory. So we can say that human beings up to this stage, that is of the last true Homo sapien, passed through the Australopithecus, Gingenthropus, Pithecanthropus, Java, Cro-Magnon, Neanderthal, and ultimately the true Homo sapiens. So during this journey, the outer skull of the man when it was in the stages of the apes was large, but the cranial capacity was a little bit less there. But with the passage of time, as the human being or on the process of the evolution, the skull size decreased and the cranial capacity or the size of the brain inside that increased. So that we discussed in the last class, that was the simultaneously we discussed the origin of the Earth and the evolution of the human being. And in that process, I told you people one thing more, and that was the concept of the AD and BC, which is known to most of you. So from 4.6 billion we entered into the million, to the 10 lakhs, to lakhs, and when we reached the time period of the 3.5 or the 3500 BC, 3500 years. So from these 3500 years up to 1300 years, that was the time period of the Indus Valley Civilization, which also crossed three important phases. The first was the early phase that started from the 3500, or some scholars believe that it was the 3300. So from 3300 to 2800 was the early phase. That was the early phase, that was the beginning of the Harappan civilization phase. And from 2800 to 1800, that was the matured form of the Indus Valley civilization. And from 1800 to 1300 was the decline or the downfall of the Indus Valley civilization. So this we discussed in last class in details also. So from today we will start from that portion which we left in the last class. And that was the pre-Harappan and the proto-Harappan cultures. So students, I told you this pre and proto both are the before Harappan culture, but proto-Harappans are more close as compared to the Harappan culture. As compared to the pre-Harappan culture, proto are much close to the Harappan culture. So we can say that the Harappan culture or the Indus Valley civilization origin ultimately emerged from the pre-Harappan and the proto-Harappan cultures. But till the script of the Indus Valley civilization is not deciphered, we are not in a methodical position to say that yes, it was the origin of the Indus Valley civilization, because the script of the IVC, that is the Indus Valley civilization, is still undeciphered. But we, up to a great extent, we can say that it had its origins in the Indian subcontinent itself and not outside the subcontinent. That was the Mesopotamia, that was believed by the Gordon Child, Mortimer Wheeler, or the John Marshall like scholars. They believed that it was the offshoot of the Mesopotamian. But the views of different scholars and the proof given by the different scholars also, they all indicated the indigenous origin of the Indus Valley civilization. So let's start here. So I told you people about the Balochistan. This Balochistan is in Pakistan area, and there is a place called Mehragarh, that is the Kachi Plains of the Balochistan. And it was the area that witnessed the pre-Harappan phase. That was the time period of the 7000 BC across period was there. And the first phase of this Mehrgarh was the early phase or the S-Arabic phase. This was the early phase, and second was the late phase also. So in the early phase, what do you understand by the term S-Arabic? S-Arabic is when we say that ceramic phase. So ceramic phase is that when the human beings in their initial stages of the civilization, when they were on the path to have a civilization, they used the earthen pots or the utensils made of the clay. So that was the ceramic phase. And this is the aceramic phase. We have used the alphabet A. A hum ne yahan pe prefix kiya hai. We have used the alphabet A before the ceramic to make it aceramic. So that was the phase when they didn't use the earthen pots or the utensils made of the clay. They didn't use that. They didn't use that. That what they used, because their life was not settled before this phase. So in the early phase, they just came on the plain area from the Baluchi hills. So and that was the transition phase. That's why it is written here. It was the transition phase from Baluchi hills to the plains. So in the ceramic phase, around the time period of the 7000 to 6000 BC, they came and settled on the plains. And after settled on the plains, they started the domestication of animals also, and the agricultural production was also started. So when the agricultural production was started, we can say that that was the beginning of the settled life. So that was the beginning of settled life, and after this settled life, they will approach toward a more mature and more developed phase also, that we will discuss in the late phase of when we will get numbered houses, etc. So here is the domestication of animal was there, and agriculture production in which wheat and barley was their main crops. And this wheat and barley was the staple crop of the Indus Valley civilization people also. So somewhere this wheat and barley linked the early phase to the mature phase of the urban civilization. Besides this, in the second phase, we get what? The mud houses were there. Secondly, the pottery was also there. Pottery, that is the utensils made of the clay, the earthen pots were there. Besides this, at this Mehrgarh, first of all, the cotton cultivation in the Indian subcontinent was also started first in the Mehrgarh, and later it was introduced, the cotton was introduced by the Indus Valley civilization people also, that in their matured phase from 2800 BC to 1800 BC. So when the people of the Harappan civilization used this cotton, that was already used by the people of the Mehrgarh phase also. So here, yes, what I want to focus on the particular point, and that is that it was the people who are living in this area, and these people with the passage of time ultimately graduated into the people of the Harappan civilization itself, and they were not the people who came from outside the country, rather they were the people of the Indian subcontinent itself. Let us discuss these points also. So cotton was cultivated there first time in the Indian subcontinent. Then beads of stone also we discovered at the Mehrgarh side. And by this particular time, in the later phase, their technology was also advanced, and they started making holes or by the drilling process in the beads. So we can say that in the initial phases, that was the transition phase, when they didn't know how to grow the, how to domesticate animals and how to produce the agriculture production, in this stage they become advanced up to that stage that they're starting beads of stone by drilling techniques also. So definitely we can say that there was the development phase in the second or the late phase of the Mehrgarh phase. Besides this, they also used the lapis lazuli. So lapis lazuli was a precious stone which the Indus Valley people also used in their time period. So we can say that this lapis lazuli also show a phase of continuity, a sequence from the early Harappan to the mature Harappan phase. Then we have discovered some female figures also with the purpose of worshipping, and there was the mother goddess, that is the goddess of the fertility, was also worshipped in the Indus Valley civilization. We know it very well. So that worshipping of the female figure was already started in the Mehrgarh phase also, and which ultimately graduated into the Indus Valley people also. So by this clue, we can say that up to an extent, Mehrgarh people could be the predecessors or the precursors or the forerunners of the Indus Valley civilization of the 2800 to 1800 BC. So, and this cotton site was discovered by the John Marshall from the Neolithic site. So Neolithic site was what, as I told you in the last class also, the Paleolithic, Mesolithic and the Neolithic phase. So Neolithic was more advanced as compared to the Mesolithic, and Mesolithic was more advanced as compared to the Paleolithic. So these people, when transferred from the Baluchi hills to the plains of the Mehrgarh, they were in the Neolithic stage. So after this Neolithic stage, they came in this particular stage, and after that they achieved some development also. So that was the pre-Harappan phase of the Mehrgarh. Besides this, in Baluchistan, we discovered four important cultures also. They are the pre-Harappan culture. And the important four cultures were, besides this Mehrgarh, they were Kulli culture. So Kulli, that is the name of a place. Null culture, that is also the name of a place. Jhob culture, Jhob is also the, it's a Jhob valley. So the people who lived there, that was, they produced a culture that was called the Jhob culture. Besides this, a Quetta culture was also there. So all these cultures belong to the Mehrgarh. And after that the Baluchistan area in the Kachi plains of the Pakistan area. So in this particular areas, the Kulli culture developed, the Null culture developed, the Jhob culture developed, and the Quetta culture also developed. So these cultures anticipate the matured phase of the Harappan phase or the industrial civilization. How? Let us discuss here. Dekhi. The important sites of this Kulli culture were Kolwa, Nindowadi, and Laspela. These are the important areas. Don't get yourself confused. In so many books you will get these names also. Kolwa, that is the name of the place, that is the name of an area. This Nindowadi was also an area, Laspela was also an area, and these areas belong to the Kulli culture. Kulli culture. And this Kulli was there, that was the area or the place in the Baluchistan. So what, and this Kulli culture was discovered by Orenstein, an important archaeologist. So what we found from this Kulli culture, to which we can say that it anticipated the beginning of the mature phase of the Harappa. From here we discovered pinkish buff wear culture, buff color, that the something like the light brown color, and pottery was similar to the IBC. We know that the IBC people used to worship people tree. They used to worship people, they used to worship the prototype of Lord Shiva, they used to worship mother goddess also. And that worshipping of this people tree was somewhere its traces of the pottery which we discovered from the Kulli culture. Because whatever the earthen pots, the remains of the earthen pots which we have discovered from the Kulli culture, on those earthen pots we have found the figures of the people tree. You can see here also. The people tree leaves are present on the earthen pots, on the remains of the earthen pots, and these people leaves we also found in the Harappan culture. So we can say that somewhere this pottery linked to the Harappan culture in the later phase. Or if the people of the Harappan age using the people leaf pottery, or they used to worship people, and beside this, on this pottery we will get the name, we will get the figure of some animals also, like the Hampul was there. So Hampul was very much important in the Indus culture. So we, all these things, by going through all these points, we can say that the material that was being used or by the Harappan people was already in practice in the pre-Harappan culture. That's why we can say that the pre-Harappan cultures relates to the Harappan culture also. Similarly, another site we can take, that is the Null culture. It was excavated by H. Hargreaves. So here we find what? Here we found a cemetery area. Cemetery area was what? As we know that the Harappan people used to cremate the disposal of the dead by different ways. So in order to dispose the dead person, the dead bodies, they used the cemetery area. So that cemetery area we have found in the Null culture also. And that cemetery area known as the cemetery H and cemetery R37 in the Harappan phases. So you can, definitely we can compare or we can link the Indus Valley civilization, the proper mature Harappan civilization, with the cemetery area of the Null culture, because the cemetery area was in the Null culture also, and in the later in the cemetery H and cemetery R37 area of the Harappan culture also. So so we are seeing a link between the two, and that we have to prove. That we have to prove, because here we are trying to prove that Indus Valley people didn't come outside the country, that is the Mesopotamia, that was claimed by John Marshall, that was claimed by Mortimer Wheeler and Gordon Child. But we are trying to focus the views of those scholars, the scholars like Raymond and Brigid Elchin was there, then Stuart Peacock was there, then G.F. Dale was there, then Rafiq Mughal was there. All these scholars are trying to focus their view on this particular point, that Harappan culture ultimately emerged or grew from the pre-Harappan cultures of the Gulli Nal Jorhat Quetta, and the evidences are in front of you. Then there was a residential area just like the Harappan people. Harappan people had the citadel area, and that was for the upper class, and the lower area for the common people. The residential area was also there. Then the stone weights were also being used by the people of the Nal culture, and stone weights and measure concept was there. And the weights and measure concept was there in the Harappan people also, because their common weight was of the 13.7 gram. That was the common weight of the Indus Valley people. Besides this, the people of the Nal culture also traded with the Persian Gulf, and the people of Indus Valley civilization definitely they also traded with the Mesopotamian people. And there are two trading station, Dilmun and Makran, in between the Indus and the Mesopotamia. So trading station was definitely there, and because we found the seals of both the Mesopotamia and Harappa on these two particular trading station, that was the Makran and the Dilmun. So trading was also there, weight was also there, symmetry was also there, graveries was also there, and people leaves that were decorated. Pottery was there. So all these features indicate that ultimately because these are the features of the 3300 to 3000 BC across period, and this period ultimately converted into the 2800 period of the Indus Valley civilization. So it's clear fact that the Indus Valley people didn't come outside, but the script is undeciphered. Till the script is not deciphered, we are not in an authoritative position to say yes, that it was the people of the Indus Valley civilization. But more and more indications we are getting, we can't avoid them also. Yes. Next is the Zhob culture. The important sites of the Zhob cultures are the Periyana Gundai, Mughal Gundai, and the Rana Gundai. So these are the important sites of the Zhob culture, just like the sites of the Kulli culture. What are the sites of the Kulli culture? The Kolwa, the Lindowari, and the Lasbela. So these are the important sites. Jaga ke naam hai ye, and their main place was the Kulli or the Nal or the Zhob. So Zhob, there is a Zhob valley, and those who would live around that valley, they were the people, and the culture they developed that became known as the Zhob culture. So important sites of these are the Periyana Gundai, Rana Gundai, and the Mughal Gundai. So what we have discovered from these? So a stone phallus is discovered from the Periyana Gundai, and phallus worship was definitely very much in the Indus Valley civilization also. So this stone phallus ultimately linked with the phallus worship of the Indus Valley people. So there is a connection. Secondly, from Mughal Gundai you get a Ulva. That could be the later days mother goddess or the goddess of the fertility that was worshipped by the people of the Indus Valley civilization. Thirdly, Rana Gundai. So Stuart Pigott, who was a very important archaeologist from the Scotland, England, he divided the Rana Gundai into 5 stages. He excavated the site of the Rana Gundai, and there he discovered 5 stages, just like the 7 stages or 7 layers of the Mohenjo-Daro, which was discovered by John Marshall in the Lakhana district of Sindh, Pakistan. So what he excavated there, he excavated 5 cultures, 5 culture phases from Rana Gundai. The first phase was what? It is undecorated handmade pottery, definitely undecorated, because that was the beginning of the making of the pottery. So in the initial stages, the size and the shape was also not perfect because it was handmade. Later it became the wheel made, and when it became the wheel made, after that they started decorating with the different motifs also, like the bull motif was there, like the peacock was also there, like the people leaves were there that we have seen in the Kulli culture also. So but in the initial stages it was handmade, and before phases like the Mehragad phase, that was a ceramic phase. It was a ceramic phase. That's why the pottery, we couldn't get the pottery from in the first phase of the Mehragad. But here, by this particular time, the potteries were there, but they were undecorated and the handmade pottery. That was the first phase. In the second phase, wheel-made pottery we have found. The wheel-made pottery definitely much more developed, advanced as compared to the handmade also. In the third phase was a long phase, that's why it is given the title of the continuation of the first and the second phase. Then in the fourth and fifth phase was the post-Harappan phase. The post-Harappan phase, that is the overlapping of the Indus Valley phase. And in the last class, students, I told you people that if we want to give some cultures the status of the Harappan culture, then those cultures to whom we are going to give the status of the Harappan culture must fulfill two conditions. First, most culture should precede the Harappan culture, and secondly, they should overlap the Harappan culture also. So, if the preceding is there definitely, and proper Harappan cultures are also there, where is the preceding? Preceding is in the aceramic phase. That is less developed phase. And developed phase was what? Developed phase was that when the pottery was similar to the IBC in the people leaves form. That was the developed phase. So, from the less developed, that was the aceramic phase, that was the transition phase when domestication of animal and production of the agricultural production of wheat and barley was just started. That was the beginning. And after that, we are getting the mud house. But in those stages, we are getting houses of much more developed form. Then in the Zoic culture, fourth and fifth was the overlap phase also. So, what we have discussed here and what we have discovered here is that these sites show the preceding of the Harappan culture as well as the overlapping of the Harappan culture is also there. So conditions are being fulfilled up to a good extent. But again, I repeat, till the script of IBC is not deciphered, we are not in a concrete or in an authoritative way, in an authoritative position to say that the Indus Valley people belong to the subcontinent of the Indian subcontinent. But we can't avoid such type of facts which are in front of us. So that is there. So this is over here. Yes, students. So till now we have discussed how the pre-Harappan cultures could be the precursors of the Harappan culture. We have discussed the different pre-Harappan cultures, including the Mundi gang of the southeastern Afghanistan area, then Baluchistan area of Pakistan, then different Baluchi cultures like the Kulli, Nal, Jok, Quetta. We have discussed and tried to find out that what could be the similarities between them. But similarities was there definitely, just like the precious stone was there. Both the civilizations used the precious stones, like the lapis lazuli was there, that was used by the Baluchi cultures also and later by the Harappan cultures also. So we can say that the one culture anticipated the other, or the other followed the first one. So these precious stones were there. So graffiti on the quotes we have discovered in the Mehrgarh and in the Baluchi cultures, and that graffiti could be the forerunner of the Harappan script. That is the language of the Harappan script, that is the post operative language. So graffiti could be converted into the language also. That's an assumption only. Then the worshipping of these Baluchi cultures, like the phallus worship was there, like the vulva worship was there. So, and that type of worshipping we have seen in the Harappan cultures also, like the mother goddess, or that is also known as the goddess of the fertility. They used to worship that. Then they used to worship the phallus, and link worship was also there in the Harappan culture. And rather we can say that the prototype of Lord Shiva was there in the Harappan culture, which is the present day Lord Shiva. So that is a survival and continuity of the Harappan culture in the present culture also. So that's a survival and continuity, and is sequenced from the that much of long period also. So what we can say that in spite so many similarities between the Baluchi cultures and the culture of the Harappan period, still we can't give the status to this pre-Harappan culture of the Harappan culture. Why? Because as I told you in the last video, I told you that this Harappan culture was a fully matured and the urban culture. But the culture which we have discussed in the Baluchi hills of the, either it was the Kulli culture or the Nal culture or the Jok culture or the Quetta culture, they were the rural culture. So they, because of that, differences between the Baluchi cultures or the Mehrgarh culture or the Mundiga culture or the different sites which we have discussed in the Baluchi cultures like the Rana Gundai, Pereni Gundai or Mughal Gundai, we have definitely, no doubt, we have discovered many things which resemble with the Harappan cultures later. But the main obstacle is that this culture belong to the rural area or the rural cultures, not the urban cultures. And that was a drawback only. By that, we can't say these three Harappan cultures ultimately graduated into the Harappan culture. So that was the drawback definitely there. Okay. Now we have to, but we can't avoid the similarities also. Now we are going to discuss the proto-Harappan cultures, which are much more linked to the direct Harappan culture as compared to the pre-Harappan culture. So when we discuss the proto-Harappan culture, we have to discuss the Amri, Koddiji and Kalibangan. These three cultures, this Amri culture, then second is the Koddijian culture, and third is the Kalibangan culture of Rajasthan area. So these cultures also resembled many similarities with the Harappan culture, but similarity just like the in the pre-Harappan culture, one was the rural and one was the urban. So similarly here also we will get some points on which we can say that these cultures also not directly graduated into the Harappan culture. So first we discuss the similarities, then we discuss the dissimilarities also, and after that we will discuss the foreign origins also. So this Amri culture, it was excavated by N.G. Majumdar, important scholar and archaeologist in 1929, and the geographical location of this Amri is 160 km south of Mohenjo-daro. That is the Mound of the Dead, or that is Mohenjo-daro known as. And there are different phases of the Amri culture. The first phase, first, second and third phases of the Amri culture we have to discuss with the Harappan culture. So by the end of the first phase, when the first phase was going to an end, there was the beginning of the Harappan culture in the last phase of this Amri culture. And by the third phase of the Amri culture, there was the complete amalgamation of the Harappan culture with the Amri culture also. So that was the similarity between the Amri culture and the Harappan culture by the third stage of the Amri culture. So one point was that. Besides this, how we can say that there is a similarity? Because in the metal work and the pottery from which we have discovered from the Amri, particularly a type of pottery of the beaker pottery which the science students use in the chemistry labs. So that is a beaker type pottery particularly we have discovered from the Amri, and that we have discovered in the Harappan cultures also. So that is also a point of similarity. Besides this, the wheel made pottery with animal motifs and the rectangular houses of same type both shared by the Amri and the Harappans, and up to a very good extent as compared to the pre-Harappan cultures. That's why they are designated the status of the proto-Harappan culture much more close to the Harappan proper as compared to the pre-Harappan culture. So we have seen some similarities between the proto-Harappan culture of the Amri. But the conflicting point is that we didn't have any evidences of the writings and town planning and seals and weights at the Harappa, which definitely we had at the Harappa, because writing skills was definitely there, their script is written on the seals and on the potsherds also. Their script was written, but the script is undeciphered. So the writing skill was not there with the Amrians people. So that's why we hesitate up to an extent how we can say that the Harappan culture ultimately was the offshoot of this Amri culture. So that was the drawback. Secondly, the town planning was not up to that mark which the Harappans had of the Amri. Then seals and weights also we couldn't discover from the Amri sites, because seals and these weights, 13.6, that was the common weight of the Harappan people was there at the Harappa sites, but we couldn't get at the Amri sites. So in brief, we can say that some features of the Amri definitely meet with the requirement of the Harappan culture, but some loopholes are also there, just like the writing skill was not there, we couldn't find there. Town planning was not there as far with that of the grid pattern of the Harappan sites. Then the seals and weights also we couldn't get. So these are the, we can say that because of these points we can't give the status of Amri to the Harappan, in spite of the other features similar also. Then second phase, the second site of the proto-Harappan is the Kodichin site. It was excavated by F.A. Khan in 1955-57. And here the lower layer represents by pre-Harappan culture and upper layer was typically Harappan. So lower layer was of the Kodichin culture, but the upper layers, what is the meaning of this, the lower layer and the upper layer? When the archaeologists excavate the sites, so they get different type of stages there and different type of phases there when they excavate, and that type of seven layers we discovered from Mohenjo-daro, three layers from Amri also, and several layers from the this Kodichin also. So the lower layers was typically Kodichin, but the upper layers was definitely somewhere under the influence of the Harappan. So that's why we can say that this Kodichin culture also graduated ultimately into the Harappan cultures also. How the painted pottery was there, wheel made pottery was there, which was light and thin also. Light and thin means it was much more developed technologically by this particular time. But the writing skills were also not there. Because of these writing skills, we can't compare the Kodichin culture as par with the Harappan culture. So writing skill was also not there, and writing skill was also not there. Rather, both are the proto-Harappan culture sites, Amri and the Kodichin, but this didn't have the writing skills, and those people didn't know the writing and the town planning and the seals, etc. So that's why these are the loopholes of these. Then third is the Kalibandhan site is also there. So this first is the Amri, then after that Kodiji is there. Amri, Kodiji, and one more is the Kalibangan. So this Kalibangan is also the pre-Hadapan culture. This is also called the Sodhi culture by A. Ghosh. That was an important archaeologist. So here also we found on the pottery, fish scale, and people leaf was definitely there. And this people leaf we have found in the culture of the Kuli and Nal also, which we have discussed just now. So this people leaf and fish scales was on the pottery. And the pottery was wheel made just like the pottery of the Harappan. So that is the signs of the similarity. Metal working of copper was known both to them. But again, the sanitary arrangement was not there at the Kalibangan at par at which we had discovered at the Harappan and the Mohenjo-daro and the sites. Their sanitary arrangement was very much up to the mark. We can say that every house had their own drain, and that drain used to meet the common street drain, and that street drain. Then that drain will link with the main drain of the entire city. So their sanitation, I should not hesitate in comparing in saying that the sanitation system of those Harappan was more advanced of the sanitation of the present time India in which we are living. You can say just after two or three showers of heavy rain, the water logging is completely there. But that type of technology the Harappans had, the water logging problem was not there because of their sanitary system. But that sanitary system and arrangements was not as much clear as in the other Harappan sites at the Kalibangan. Besides this, writing skills and weights was also we couldn't find from there also. So because of these lacunas or loopholes, you can say that we are not able to say in a perfect form. We can't say that these proto-Harappan cultures were ultimately graduated into the Harappan cultures. So in spite of the fact, similarities are definitely there, but because of these dissimilarities, somewhere we are not able to say that these proto-Harappan cultures and the pre-Harappan cultures were the originator of the Harappan culture. So these were the indigenous view, which was supported by the important scholars like the Brigadier and Raymond Elgin is there. And Stuart Pigott also says that Rafiq Mughal is also there, WFDLC is also there. So these scholars believe that the Harappan culture belonged to the indigenous culture, and the people of the Harappa didn't come outside the country. And we have tried to compare how these pre-Harappan and proto-Harappan cultures could be the forerunners of the Harappan culture. But on certain points, we can't say that they were the forerunners of the Harappan culture. That was the one point. Secondly, we have to discuss the other side of the origin, and that was the foreign origin, because these pre-Harappan and proto-Harappan origins were of the indigenous origin or the origins, which means we can say that they were emerged from the Indian subcontinent. Then we have to discuss the foreign